Kobe's all right, because he hit me kind of hard at first. Yeah. But I'm going to pray for him. Hope he's all right. That's it.
Anything else for these guys?
Jordan, you're able to go to the basket. You're making some short jump shots, also going to the basket and help and made a couple 3-point plays.
I just pick my team up. My team up a lot because it starts with me first. Once I bring the intensity, everybody else just come on, join the intensity. So that's what I have to do every single game. Just bring a lot of intensity because once I bring intensity, everybody else gonna bring more intensity.
What were you thinking when you were playing with 4 fouls at the end?
I was just thinking to let them score. But my coach said every time you get 4-3 fouls, it's just 2 points, just let them score. So that's what I did.
Anything else? Thanks, guys.
Go ahead, guys. I guess I'm just going to start with I'm proud of our guys for their effort, but most importantly, I hope Curtis Cobb of Fairfield is okay. He had a pretty significant injury there in the first half, so our prayers and thoughts go with him, first of all. And after that, I thought both teams competed really hard, and we're happy to get the win.
Tim, you were disappointed with Jordan's first half at Quinnipiac, and obviously had the foul trouble last time out of Manhattan.
Yeah.
What did you think of his response today with the 30?
Well, Jordan had probably his 2 best practices since we've had him here the last 2 days. He actually paid attention to detail and actually wanted to work hard the entire practice for 2 days in a row. Things that we've been imploring to try to get out of him. I think the last game, you know, helped him to start to develop and realize that he has to do a lot more than what he's been doing for our team to be successful.
Coach, you got a lot from Sam Cassell and from John Sevier. They really seem to complement each other today.
Well, they did a really nice job, and I think they're taking some leadership of this team, which is why we brought him in there, them both in here in the first place. And I'm really happy for the way they've been playing and the leadership they brought to our team.
As they were making that run in the second half, they cut it to 6, and then EJ knocked down that 3.
It was a big 3, yeah.
How has he grown as a player and as a freshman that he could be relied on?
I can tell you, from the first game against them to this game, I thought he was a freshman in his eyes and the way he went out to that first game, a little bit nervous. This game he played a lot more under control. The game slowed down for him and just let it come to him. And I think as he does that, he's been more and more of an Iona player and done a really good job for us.
Is it a little difficult to sort of keep your foot on the gas when something like that happens to Curtis?
Yeah, we were worried that that was going to take the momentum away from us at that time because obviously it's a lot more important than basketball.
Tim, through most of the night before Fairfield went on a run midway through the second half, it seemed like the performance from one of your older teams, from the 2 NCAA teams on top of that, has to help. Please worry with the way you shot the ball, shared it as well in the first half.
I thought we had moments. I thought there was too much time in between where the ball was sticking again tonight. I wasn't as happy as I was the other night against Manhattan. I thought we floated a lot better. And today we floated the Spurs, but we have to be able to play both ends for 40 minutes, and we didn't do that tonight.
Coach, do you feel like the 2 wins this week put you in a good position for the second half of the conference?
All I worry about is the next game. I don't really start looking to who we're playing 2 games, 3 games down the road. We have to just get better every time out, and hopefully we'll be at our peak when we hit March.
Anything else?
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Coach.